Okay, so good morning everyone and welcome back in today's class. Okay, so till yesterday what we discussed specifically on the service now area, user creation, group, role assignment, all the things we discuss. Okay, and we discuss about the update set as well, that what is the update set and what is the purpose of update set. Okay, today we will see that how I can create update set or what is the life cycle of an update set specifically. Okay, so for that I'll just log out and log in from my ID. I log in from the system admin, so I'll go by my ID so that I can use and I can create my personal update set. Okay, now the point which is important is that update set is not important for you. When I say for you means for the consulting perspective, it is not important because you are not going to write any kind of a code or something in the service now. Update set is important from the developer perspective because developer is making changes and he or she need to be capture his changes in some of the container, and that container we called as a update set. Okay, so first of all, what I will do, I'll go here on the setting button and bring the update set menu on the top here. So what you can do, I can go here, go to the developer and then enable it. Show update set picker in the header. It means if I enable it, it will come on the top like this. Okay. The default update set, there's a default as well. The default update set is default global. You can see here this one, default global. In your personal instance, if you see, you will find default global has been selected by default here. Now the thing is that never ever capture any changes in the default update set. Either you have to make a change of one dot, or either you want to make a change of 100 of the code lines. Always create your own update set. If I speak in very layman language, agar aap apna saman अपने मम्मी या पापा के बॉक्सेस में रखना शुरू करेंगे, इट लेटर ऑन इट्स प्रॉब्लम फॉर यू व्हेन यू रीच देयर. सो बेटर कीप द थिंग्स ओनली इन योर बॉक्सेस एज वेल, एंड दीज आर द बॉक्सेस ओनली, नथिंग एल्स. सो नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल गो हियर. ओके, दिस थिंग ओनली कैन बी डन बाय द एडमिन. आईटीएल यूजर अप्रूवर, नो वन कैन डू दिस थिंग. ओनली द एडमिन, सिस्टम एडमिन कैन डू दिस थिंग इन द सिस्टम. सो आई विल गो हियर and search for the update set. Okay, so you can see system update set is a module and I have multiple applications are there. Update set log, retrieve update set, local update set, merge update set commit, commit history. Now for this particular session, we will discuss only the local update sets. Update set log, retrieve, merge, we will see when we are moving our changes from one instance to the other instance. Maybe after 10, 15 days, 20 days, I will ask, okay, Ronald, give me your instance. I will bring my changes. I will bring these changes into Ronald instance as well. So why I'm picking up this topic beginning, because I want to capture your changes in a one place so that after 20, 25 days, I will ask you, okay, Ronald, aap apne changes Surya ke instance mein leke jao. Surya, aap apne changes Ronald ke instance mein leke jao. So that we can see how this update set movement actually works. So now I'll go and click on the local update set here. And I will create my update set. So now you can see this, a lot of update set has been created by previous students only. Okay. And now I'll click on the new update set. Update set means I'm creating a new box here to capture my changes. Now what I'll put, H6 ठीक है, that is the name of my update set. Means this is the briefcase where you mention your name, that okay, this belong to Ronald, this belong to Surya, this belong to Veer, this belong to Ankit, or this belong to Kunal. Always make sure the state should be in progress until unless you are okay. हाँ भाई, mom, all packing done, can I lock it? Yes, once you lock, you cannot reopen it. In the same manner, once you close, sorry, once you complete, best practice says never reopen it. But हमारे इंडस्ट्री में चलता है ये भी. बट अगेन आई एम गोइंग फॉर द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिस. दैट इज आई एम सेइंग आइदर इफ यू वांट टू एड अ डॉट, क्रिएट अ न्यू बॉक्स एंड एड द डॉट देयर ओनली. ओके, सो मेक श्योर यू आर पुट इन द इन प्रोग्रेस. पेरेंट, नाउ व्हाट इज द पेरेंट मीन्स हियर. लेट्स एग्जांपल, वी आर द 5 स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस बैच. ओके, आई एम वन ऑफ द पर्सन हियर हु नो दिस थिंग्स इन द फ्रॉम द बेसिक्स एज वेल. ओके, बट आई से let's do one thing, Ronald, Surya, Kunal, everybody. I will create my update set and you guys add your update set in the same. Let's take a IT example. We have a sprint or we have a requirement. Let's say I have a requirement of the creation of the home page. Okay, that is the major requirement, or that is a one single requirement. Under that requirement, I have a sub requirement. Create the 2 phase that I assigned to Ronald. I have one more requirement under the same thing. Click creation of the 2 button, okay or cancel. I assigned to Kunal. I have one more requirement in the same. I want to display a hyperlink on the top that I assigned to Surya. Now you 3 guys are working on a same kind of requirement. Parent is same, right? अब ऐसा नहीं होगा कि मैं रोनाल्ड का चेंज ले जाऊंगा और कुणाल का चेंज छोड़ दूंगा, क्योंकि उससे मेरा रिक्वायरमेंट कंप्लीट नहीं होगा. सो व्हाट आई विल डू इन दिस केसेस, बेसिकली दिस केसेस हैज बीन प्रेफर्ड. तो उस केस में हम क्या करते हैं, एक पेरेंट अपडेट सेट बना लेते हैं, जस्ट टू मेक श्योर कि जो इस द रिक्वायरमेंट्स द चेंजेस व्हिच आई नीड फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर रिक्वायरमेंट शुड बी कैप्चर इन अ वन प्लेस. ठीक है, वो लेट्स एग्जांपल. Suppose I'm shifting from from Pune to some other place. Okay, I take a big box. In big box, I put small boxes for the crockery. Okay, this is the plates, this is cup, this is kettle, this is my another crockery saman, all these things. So that whenever I reach on the destination, I will open that big box and I will get the all other things in the place. So it is up to you. It is basically not up to you, it is basically up to your scrum master or tech lead that he want to go for a single update set or the parent update set with the combination of the child as well. So it is up to you. So let me do, I'll add one more update set here. Learn and grow. Okay, or let's do one thing. Let me make a new update set for myself first. Learn, grow, batch 6. Okay. Let take this as a parent update set. Okay, release date you want to mention, just for the recording purpose you want to mention, you can mention, otherwise you can leave it. Okay, now what I will do, I'll click on the submit. I'm not putting any parent, but when you guys will create a update set, you need to put this as a parent. Now
let's add batch 6 over
there. Oh sorry, yes, batch 6, yeah. Okay, so when you guys will create an update set, you have to put this into the parent. Now what I'll do, I have 3 options: submit, save, submit and make current. What this means, basically I will submit this and now this default has been changed to this particular update set. It means all the changes, all the practical things which we are going to be discussed for the upcoming 10, 15, 20 days, everything will be captured in this area now. So that at the later on, I'll say, okay, now I'm happy to move the changes to the your instance. So now I click on the submit and make current. So let me open this one. So now you can see your current update set has been changed to the learn, grow, this one. You can see here now this is. It means now if I teach you anything, if I show you anything, if we make any modification in the logic, everything will be captured here. Let open this. So now I'm getting this update sets. So suppose now Ronald create one update set. Okay, so and he add this update set as a parent. So Ronald update set will be appear in this area for me. In this area, so the child update sets. You can try Ronald at your end once. Or maybe Kunal, if anybody is logging from the laptop, just go and create one update set and add this update set as a parent.
Okay.
Surya, you also try. Kunal, you also try.
Yes, this we are doing in your instance or
my instance only. Why my instance? So that I can ask you to move your changes into your instance later on.
Okay.
Like in your instance with our username, right?
With your username, correct. Let me try to pull Ankit and Virendra as well once again. Try once again. So once you're done, just and always make sure that you make it as a your current, so that all your changes should be go in this area now. If you are a consultant, you will never use this. Yeah, tell me.
Should I submit and make it a current?
Yes, submit and make it current. Always make sure that you edit this as a parent. Okay, so that I can see in this area.
Yeah, updated it.
Okay, let me see. Yep, now you can see here. I have one update set, Surya update set is there. Okay, so this is the way we always follow. But again, this depend from customer to customer, company to company, developer to developer as well. Someone says putting into the parent is a risky part. Suppose few of the changes you don't want to go as a in the parent, then you have to be make it as a out from that area. Okay, so that's totally depend on you that how you want to take care of that part.
In simple terms, like if a work will be splitted by two to three people, then we will be using this parent update set.
Correct. When you are always sure that okay, all changes will go in a one go, pieces mein nahi jayenge.
And the same, like two to three developers are working on the same work.
Correct.
Parallelly.
Right.
It's done.
Yeah. See. Okay. Mine is also.
Yes, here is also there. Okay, so this is a topic which we discuss. Now forget about update set. Nothing to be worried. We will pick up this update set in the later on.
Okay. Okay. Now, for example, I was working on my own personal instance, right? And okay. Up until yesterday.
Okay.
Now I created some users and etc. So maybe I made some changes. Right. Mm-hmm. So I didn't know that it was up until yesterday, it was going to the default update set.
Right.
So now those changes that I made, are they part of the default update set?
Default. Let me show you. Where is the default of mine? See, so I have a lot of plugin installed. So for every plugin, they have a default update set as well.
Okay.
Where is my default? This one. Yeah, this one. Let's see.
Correct.
So like you can see here, I have these many changes has been done in my default. That is the reason always be cautious on that part. As soon as you start working on the development of in service now, better you create your update set. And Ronald, in update set, we are not capturing the data. आपने यूजर बनाया वो यहाँ पर नहीं आएगा देखो यहाँ पे यूजर्स नहीं आएंगे
अच्छा ओके ओनली
कॉन्फ़िगरेशन कस्टमाइजेशन लॉजिक्स एसएलए ईमेल दीज थिंग्स विल कम इवन आई रीड इट समवेयर दैट इवन रिपोर्ट्स एंड डैशबोर्ड आल्सो नॉट कैप्चर्ड इनटू द अपडेट सेट
ओके Yeah, okay, because that is based on data, right?
Yes, okay. But you can forcefully add them as well. But people, I read in the committee, people say that sometimes it's work, sometimes it did not work. So now the question comes, Atul, how I will move my data from one instance to another instance? Ab dekho, aapne, now you get it 100 of users in your instance. Now you want to bring that 100 users in my instance. It is not a good practice that you create one by one in my instance. It means there is some other way is available which can help me to bring your data into my instance as well. That we'll discuss in the import export time. Okay.
Okay, got it. Okay, thanks.
Okay. Now let's come to the this part. So this has been done. Introduction, update set movement we'll see on the later on. Now let's come on the basic things here. Okay, and I'm not sure that you cannot do the some practice on this area. Let me go to the home page. Now we will see that from where these things are coming. Okay, and what is this? If I click on this, what is this UI15? Okay. In ServiceNow, we have two type of properties. Okay. Number one is called the system property. And number two is called the module specific property. When I say the system property, the property which belong to your particular system, like your mobile phone, notification sound on and off, it will applicable for all kind of notification in the phone. But if you want to change the notification for the WhatsApp, Gmail, you can define the specific notification tone as well. That is called the module level. Okay, again, all these things which we are discussing now required an admin license. Without admin, you cannot do things here. Okay, now I can go here. System properties. This one you can see. System properties, and under system properties, I have a lot of things. Now your mind will be opened by seeing, Atul, come on, from where these things are coming. There's a lot of things which we are going to be discussed in one by one, and a lot of things which you need to be explored at your end. So the first is called the basic configuration and basic configuration UI16. Let's discuss on that part. ServiceNow is famous for the user experience. Okay. If you notice that if anyone from your side has or used ServiceNow in era of 2013, 14, 15 time period. Okay, that time this was not the front end. Let me show you. That time front end was something like this. And I am one of them who use this front end actually. I started 2014-15 somewhere in ServiceNow in the Fuji release time. So I use this front end. This is called the UI 15, User Interface 15. And the current which we are using is called the UI 16. Now the question comes, Atul, why is ServiceNow still maintaining this UI 15? Number one is that ServiceNow is a user-friendly company, or the user experience has his main motto. There's a lot of people still using ServiceNow in the same format only, and they don't want to make a change in the front end. To respect their feelings, ServiceNow still maintaining the UI 15, and as of now, ServiceNow has no plan to decommission UI 15 in the coming releases as well. Okay, like the same thing. I still love to listen music on the radio itself. Even though I have a Carva, I have a YouTube, I have a Spoofy, I have a Gaana.com, everything. But still, I love to listen the music on the radio. Either it can be a transistor, it can be a mobile. But I love to listen on that part. So in the same manner, ServiceNow has these things on the place. And to do the configuration changes on this is called the basics one. Let me go back here and I'll show this thing. You can see here as well. System property, this one. This is the basic configuration, means we are on the 15. That is in dimension 16 here. UI basic configuration here. Let me open this. These text is coming from here only. Let's change it. Batch 6. Learn grow. See, can you imagine how quickly they're changing the text here? Without refresh, it has been changed. You want to change the color of this, you can do it from here. Believe me, these things has been asked by the customer. I want like this, I want like this. You want to put any banner image, you can do it from here like this. I have bringing here. Plus, and then you can go to the your system or browsing your system and you can get these things done. Let me see for batch 4 anything I have. Let me go. Where should I go here? Let me go to YouTube only. Here I will find a lot of things. Okay, let's say this one. Sometimes this image take little time to be updated, but sometimes it's quickly as well done. So now you can see it has been done. This is the UI 15. These changes will not be available on the UI 16. You want to set the date format, you want to set the GMT format, anything you want to put, you can put it here. Up to you. But the only thing is that if you make a change here, it will be applicable for everyone. It is not a personalized one. So if you want to do the practice for this system property, you can do it on your personal instance. These changes will not capture into the update set. You have to do these changes manually in the production system again. So always remember this thing. Now what I will do, I'll go and move to the UI 16. Any question till this point?
So this is much easier now in this user interface. You have to do it in this only, or it can be done in 16 as well?
16 as well.
Okay. But it seems much more easier. 16 was a little complex, I guess.
Maybe you are using 16. I'm using 16 for a long time now, so I'm comfortable with 16, but not the 15. But there are the people who are in service now from the 2010-09 as well. So they're still happy with the same only.
Okay.
And so then one all will be access for doing all these things. Only the system admin.
System admin. Only system admin can do. Okay. Now I'll go to the UI.
Atul, one more thing.
Yes, Sanket. Go ahead. Go ahead.
If we do some changes on U15, it won't reflect on U16, right?
No. Because we have a separate application here.
And how about the performance? It doesn't make any difference while performance working on 16 and 15.
Suppose our
version is Rome and we're using 16, we have to make some changes on public configuration and we make it on 15, and then while running on Rome, the performance is already enhanced, the features are already enhanced.
So these are just an interface. Nothing logic is there. It has no impact on the performance.
Okay.
So it is just ki bhai theek hai, mujhe ye screenshot pasand nahi hai, mujhe ye screenshot pasand hai, main to wo lagaunga.
Correct.
Only for the user user part. Rest everything will be same. You can open the incident here as well. You can open it here as well. Same thing will be open. Nothing. Just aapko navigate karne ke liye ek naya option de diya hai bas. If you want to minimize, maximize, you can click on this. Maximize window ho jayegi. Usme yahan hota tha, isme yahan hota hai. Nothing much. Okay. So now we will do the changes on the UI 16. See, now I'm getting this option. Ki aapko home page pe jana hai, dashboard pe jana hai. Not sure that earlier it was not coming in the 16 form. Let's see here. Still not getting. Maybe the property I pause it. Now I'll go to the system property. Basic. Now you see, we done the change in the 15, but it is not impacting here. Now I go to the UI 16. Here you can make a change. Browser tab title, you can see here. See, it's showing grow, right? From here it is becoming. See, these are changes. Then time zone you can do, image you can do, date format you can do. If you make any changes here, it will be applicable for the all users who are using my system. And if any customer, any user want to make a change, he need to go here and make a change in the personalized setting. So this is that is what I'm saying. It is a system property. Once you change, applicable for everyone. Simple part. उसके बाद अगर किसी को change करना है, they can go here and they can make a change from here. Okay. Now I'll scroll down. In 16, we have a lot of options here. See. These colors you want to change, this in के बीच में जो color change करना है, यहाँ पे जो color change करना है, a lot of things you can do it here. A lot of selected, unselected navigation icon. Let me see if something is there. We can make a change. See, these things are changing. And these are called the themes. Like in our mobile phone, we have a themes, right? In the same manner, we have a theme in our service now as well. Let me make a change of the only by default two themes are given. Lazola or Cobalt. And once you click on the save, the things will be changed. So you can make any kind of changes here. Banner text color you want to make change, this one. See. Header divider strip, this one they'll be talking specifically. I'm not sure, right or wrong. This one, right. This one there.
I think that number can be added manually also, right?
Manually, yes. If you know, you can add.
Okay.
Up to you. That is the beauty of service now. That is the reason we call it the user experience is good here.
Right.
If you know, you can make a change quickly. Okay, now let me save it.
And with this change, it would be applying for all the users, not for...
Correct. Complete system will be updated.
So theme is for personal, but the system property here is would be applicable for entire batch.
Right. Now, if I want to make a change in the theme, I can go and personalize for myself. Now, simple si baat hai. When you purchase a new phone and you do unboxing, you switch on. We never like the wallpaper which is already there. We always change. So that is the same funda. If anybody open, boss, ye theme milega. Aapko change karna, you can go and make a change here. That's not an issue for me. Okay, so this is the UI 16.1. Now I come to the my company. Okay, because when you buy ServiceNow instance, you have your own company as well registered on the same. Okay, like this, I have my company. My company name is Learn and Grow Batch 6. This one they are picked by default. Okay, generally we will discuss this, but not much here. By default, it create automatically that, okay, what is my company name? It is coming from here only. What is the logo? It is coming from logo only. Just a record has been created. Now I can see two people are watching my page here, Ankit and Surya. Again, option available for you to see that how many people are seeing my incident or my page here. And this option available for everyone in every page. If I open one incident and you also open an incident, I will get your name there. Now, if Ronald also open, it becomes the 3. If Kunal also open, it becomes 4.
This comes via property?
Via some property, yes. Yeah. But need to see which property. Okay. And these things are, you can say, as a value to the customer. Okay, that was okay. You can do these things at your end if you want. You want to see that how many people are be seeing at a single time, because what happened that if any major incident happened, it is single incident, so many people are be watching that. So you can see, okay, someone is looking into this particular thing. Either he just opened and went away, that's the another thing. But you can see, okay, people are on the page now. Okay, now I come to the UI properties. This is a big list. It is very, very, very big list. Few things I know, which I'll tell. Few things I don't know, and we can explore. Okay. Now, the first thing come basically, show names instead of email address in the activity header of the emails. If true, basically, when we can see this thing, if I open it here. I'll tell you tomorrow, maybe when we discussion on the table level, I'll tell you that what is the tricks we can use here. Okay. Wait, let me move number on the top. Now let me open this. So what property is saying that show the names instead of the email address in the activity header of an email. Okay. Somewhere it is talking about these things here. Like this assigned to or some email addresses are there. Okay. If you make it true, it has some other look. If you make it as false, it will have, if none is found, email address is displayed. So like this. Agar, ठीक है. So basically, I never tried this option, but it is just for the easiness of a user that how he want to see it's a name or the email addresses. So maybe once we reach on this part, what I can say, email part, then we make it as a true and we see that what changes we are able to see here on this part or in the email notification part. Okay. Now second part, you are able to see this, right? Emails are coming in the incident, right? Who can see this email? If a user has these many roles, or any user who has these roles can see. If I remove the ITIL, or if I remove the admin, let's see, I'm removing this too. And clicking on the save. Okay, and now let me try to reload this page. Let it be reloaded. I can still see it's coming from cashier or what? Because as per the role, I should not able to see here. Okay, so I can define the roles here that who is the user who can see these kind of options here. Okay, and you will surprise that in one of my account, this problem actually came. One of the customers says, Atul, I don't want to show these emails to my users. And these things we learn only from what I can say, troubleshooting only. I done a lot of R&D, and nothing has found. Then I check on the community part. So someone say it is coming from the property only. So this is the property. Now the question come on the committee, you will find that it is a property and they give the property name. But here this is no property has been name has been given. So click on this icon. This is the property. Glide.ui.activity.email_role is a property name. Okay. One more thing which is important to understand here. Atul, theek hai, ye English hai, it's good. But where I can go and see all the system properties or all the properties of my system, then you have to go on the table level, which I will show you tomorrow when we go for the table level discussion. Okay. Now, assigned to image used to be activity formatter, assignment group image used to activity formatter. Specifically, they are using these things. These are the activity formatter only, these things. Okay. If you want to make a changes into the images, you can do that part. Now, important point on this part is that you can add the images in ServiceNow library as well. If you click on this magnifier glass, I'll show you. The images you are able to see in ServiceNow, everything has been stored somewhere like this. Now you can see any button, any like this, you are able to see, right? This, all these are be coming from here only. See, this has been come when your updating is there, right? This is come when you're downloading the report. So you can see here. So if you want to add, you can add your own library as well. On your image, sorry, you can add image in the library as well. And this is coming from the other table. See, image picker is a table name here. These things are very minute, which nobody cares actually, and nobody interested in that. But sometimes it is important for a consultant to see from where these are coming. Like this, you can see RSS feeds are there, right? SAP, there's your save button is there. Your next, these buttons are there. So if you want to make a change, you can change. Or you can do want to see something else, animated want to see. only animated images will come here. You want to see only editors.
Till all these properties will be accessible only from the system admin, right?
Only. So now, as I told, going forward, any changes which we are making in service now will be only taken care by the system admin. ITL user cannot see these things.
Even that banner frame editing also.
Nothing. Simple si baat hai. A guest who is coming at your home is not allowed to make any changes in your home other than your father, mother, or yourself.
Yeah.
So you are the admin now of your home, right? You can make n number of changes, but your guests cannot make a single change, not a single dot. Okay. So from there, you can pick up the images. What I can be say here, you can try to make a changes in this image. Certify, you put some other image and see that what changes are coming here. That is easy for you to be understand. Okay, these changes are there. Okay. Now, important point is this. You are able to see this button where it is gone. Let me go to the user ID. And click on the James Wood. Now you see on this form, I have update, I have insert, I have insert and stay, I have save. What is the purpose of this save and update in a single place? Why I need these two things on a single form?
Update will make the changes, but will not take you out of this form. But save will save the changes and take you back to the previous form.
What do you say, Kunal?
Yeah, I feel update is like kind of like it's hit our updates it as well, kind of like I feel.
Okay, why I need update and save on the same form? And Ronald, which you told is opposite actually. Update will take out you from this page, save will keep it on the same page.
Oh, okay.
But the question come, why I need a two options? In short, the working is same. Update or save, dono database mein jaake hi add karenge last mein. But why I need these two options?
You are fully satisfied that you don't need to do anything on the page, then you can click on update. If you have to do any more modifications after the one that you've done, probably you have to click multiple times the save option. That might be the option.
Yeah, user experience.
User experience. That is the important point. So I'll tell you one case actually. Okay, if I'm correct on that part, approximately a two or not two, huh? Approximately 3 to 4 years back, ServiceNow just have a save option here. They don't have an update option if I remember correctly. Okay, then people on the committee start putting this thing. Why you're not putting the update here? Okay, now what ServiceNow did? ServiceNow bring update button as the default on every phone. If you open your personal instance, you will find the update. You will not find the save. And they move the save into the properties. Here it is there. Save, insert, instant stay on the form. It is a property. If I untick this and let me save this. And I reload this page in the meantime. Your all other options will be gone. See. Now, ServiceNow say, boss, it is up to your customer requirement. If they want, enable it. But don't come back to me and say, boss, mujhe to save hi chahiye, insert aur stay nahi chahiye. Nahi, aise nahi chalega. Ya to tino milenge, tino nahi milenge. It is again a way to maintain the standards. Kyunki if you are giving this option to an ITL user, insert, stay, and save, he can do a mess as well. Mm. Right? So, in short, you are getting the option, but you are not allowed to use that option as well, practically. Because if I'm an ideal user, I'm a Servidas agent, just a fresher. मैंने गलती से insert paste click कर दिया. Now what will happen? It a new record will be created. Or I put insert and stay. A new record will be created. I'm changing a previous record now. So that is when it says to maintain their standards. It is a standard. You use always update. They says why you want to use save here. I am giving option. Go and click on the save here. That is always available for you. But still people say, no, I want a specific button here. Okay, use it. But responsibility on you on these two buttons. So this is coming from this particular property here. Okay. Enable the right click on the edit context menu. This one. And sorry, where it is mentioned? Context menu in the navigator. Okay. Let me go and open this.
So is that the reason probably some of the seniors are probably experienced? They use the hamburger menu, three stripes, and correct. Then click on save, or they click on right click on the form and then click on save.
Right. So okay. Now the another property come. This is enable the right click on the edit context menu on the application in the navigator. This is the navigator for me. Like this one, you want to do these things. Okay, or you want to do this thing like this. So you can do enable or disable from this property easily. Okay. Allow attachment drag and drop option. If I want to attach any record, let me go and open it. Let me go here. Okay. So what I'll do, I'll open this, open a file here. And I can drag and drop. You want to do the drag and drop, you can go. If you want to disable that property, you can disable it as well. Okay. Batch 6. This one. So now you can see. Oh, wait. I'm here, copy and put it here like this. But this property is coming, or this option is coming, because I have enabled the drag and drop option. Ye bahut bahut minute cheeze hain. Being a consultant, you should know only once or twice. But practically, agar aapko use karna hai, to aap use kar sakte hain. Now you can see attachments are there. You can do the attachment from here as well. We will discuss little more about the form on the incident time. Okay, now I'll come here. Controls how many attachment can appear on the top of the form. This way, let me do like this. Go here. Ek, do, three, seven. So copy karte hain, yahan jata hai. Yahan dal do. Theek hai. Iska matlab kya hai? Ki aapko yahan par kitni attachments show karni hai. Yahan par aapko 10 show hongi. Theek hai. Ab jaise main aur agar karun. सेम अगेन करके देखता हूं मैं, क्योंकि मुझे काउंट मिल जाएगा तो आई सी 8. ठीक है, म्यूट क्यों नहीं कर रहा भाई, बाकी तो कर दे यार. लेट मी गो बैक ऑन द बैच 4. हाँ, यहाँ मिलेगी मुझे. ठीक है, नाउ गो एंड डू इट. See, it's showing me the 15. Count is 15, but it's showing only the 10. और ये count कहाँ से आता है? ये count मेरा यहाँ से आता है. कि आपको कितने show करने हैं? Best practice is only 3, but it is up to you. क्योंकि जितना आप इसको यहाँ show करेंगे, your page length will be increase. आपको scrolling के लिए उतना करना पड़ेगा. और यहाँ पे आपको confusion हो जाएगा. See, now total is 21 and 11. If I put this property as a इसको पहले मैं कंपनी ऐड करके देता हूं इसके साथ. एंड नाउ आई सेव इट. नाउ वी चेंज द प्रॉपर्टी एज वेल. एंड नाउ यू कैन सी ओनली 3. 18 आर इन द अटैचमेंट. सो दिस इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस प्रॉपर्टीज ओनली. ओके, लिस्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम टेबल दैट हैव डिलीट ऑडिटेड. मतलब कौन कौन से रोल हैं जो डिलीट कर सकते हैं, ये रोल्स हैं जो डिलीट कर सकते हैं और किस किस टेबल पे, वो यहाँ से होगा। जनरली इन चीजों को आप कभी चेंज नहीं करेंगे, जहां पर स्पेसिफिकली रोल्स की बात आती है, वेयर वी आर यूजिंग द रोल स्पेसिफिकली, नेवर चेंज द आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स सिस्टम, इट विल क्रिएट अ मेस फॉर यू अदरवाइज। ओके, नाउ अनदर पॉइंट, नंबर ऑफ डेज इंटीजर रिजॉल्व्ड इंसिडेंट ऑटोमेटिकली क्लोज। नाउ यू सी इन योर ऑपरेशन दैट ओके इंसिडेंट गेट क्लोज ऑटोमेटिकली आफ्टर 5 days, बट भाई आता कहां से है वो? That is the actual consulting. Being a consultant, you should know ki from where these things are coming. It's coming from this one. You create one incident, put as a date as a 1. Tomorrow it will be closed. From resolve only, not from in progress. Okay. So these are the properties you can see here. You can set here. Okay. Now show button on the at the end of the form or the header. This one they're talking. These buttons. You want to show on the top or header? You can do this property changes. So you can do these things at easily at your personal instance as well, because if you make a change here, other person doing some changes will be override. Okay, so this today's part you can test in your personal instance. List of roles that can be used the global search capability. Wow, that is too awesome. Who can use this global search? Remove the ITL role, admin as well. This option will gone. Let me put control X. Save. And reload my page. I'm having some other roles kya to mujhe dikh raha hai yahan par ye, but it should not be visible to me because I removed that option, I removed that role. So you can test with the ITL user that this option will be gone. Again, this is important. This option has been asked by one of my customer. Atul, I don't want that global search should be available to my server desk. They should always go here and they can search it. That is the thing. Default choice list width. If you want to do this pixel and other things, you can do the changes here. Display missing choice list entry. Not sure. Missing choice list specifically where I saw this option. Need to be see either maybe in this choice list is this one only. यहाँ पर कुछ होगा तो वो शो करेगा यहाँ पर हमें, ठीक है। Then small one, open a new window when related object icon click true or replace current one. This is mainly specifically for these options like this. We can use it. Okay. Allow replacing current screen to the related object. Yes, true. This thing. So in this case, I can simply say that there is a number of validations, number of properties available. More you read, more you get the options. Maximum number of auto complete matches to the email client. This thing. Matches, I guess, talking about these things. These matches are there. Okay. So these things you can check at your end. Enable UI filter, form load, remember me, this one. Remove remember me checkbox from the login page. When you log in, it's showing, right? Remember me. You can remove. Why it is not allowed to do changes? Because this thing has been maintained by ServiceNow. If you want to make a changes, either you can do by elevated roles or you need to be reach out to the ServiceNow. And then they can make a changes for you. Okay, ji. Allow multiple splits within the single form. If you want to divide this form in the multiple sections, properties there. So many things are there which we cannot discuss in a single go. And more you explore, more you will be getting the options here. Show new button for many-to-many list. Number of credit display in the tooltip. This one will be having a tooltip, right? This one. Number of factors allowed. This thing. Printing more than 25,000. Okay, this is good. Alter user when printing more than following 25,000. In ServiceNow, there is a limit of getting the printing in a single go. So up to 25,000 record you can print in a one go, but not more than that. Okay, this option will come in the reporting as well. You cannot download more than 10,000 record in a one go, but you can increase from 10,000 to 1 lakh as well. But that can impact your system performance. So be careful on that particular part. Maximum record of maximum number of record allowed to reference in the display. This one, let me show you here. This is the reference field, right? So now if I go and put double asterisk, this will show 25 records in a one go. From where this property coming? This is coming from here. Let me put as a 10. And now I reload this page. And now if I go here, it's still showing. Wow, more than that. Or maybe in the incident, let me check somewhere. नहीं यार यहाँ पे भी चल रहा है, इसका मतलब property is not set properly. काम के 25 में लिखा था maximum number of records allowed reference display in the choice list. UI used. Maybe, but this property it can be used. Then number of entries, multi-line text boxes. This what is other important point left here? Pop up, maximum allowed. Okay, display none. This is a good option. Suppose you are using a radio button and you want to show the none option as well in that. So by default, if you click, it will show the none as well there. Okay, that is the thing. Number of rows to be displayed in the list view. When I go here in the list view. Open. So the default property is 20. Okay, in a list view. Because I already have set it for the 94, I guess 100, right? But default is basically on the 20 only, this one, and this is coming from this property. Okay.
What exactly is that radio button?
Radio button basically, if you want to say male or female, it's yes or no or none. Are you coming? Maybe, may not be, none. So then it will be work. When we go for the table creation now, then I'll show you these options as well, that how you can use the radio button. Okay, so tomorrow we are going to start with the table creation, application creation, and then I'll show that what are the data fields or data types are available and how this can be utilized.
And then isn't there any option that the save button has been fixed at the top of the banner or somewhere like that? Because like for every time you are going up and then you are saving it, right?
In that. Yes. So no. It is either up or it is either down. At the top of the form, at the end of the form, because you cannot put it this way, right?
No. That bar itself has been like fixed or like.
Yes. It has been fixed completely. Okay. Now unlock empty URLs not required, do navigation. This is where we are. Okay. Allow the user to insert and stay option at the task drive tables. Task drive basically, when we create a table, when we do for a table session tomorrow, I'll tell you that how you can create a table from the another table as well. Okay, that option they are saying that, okay, I don't want to use this option on the incident change or problem, then you can make it as a yes, so that user should not able to see these options. Okay. Enable global search is there. Okay, it's need to be removed this actually, only then it will be go out. Okay. Global search text message per table, minimum record should be 30. And rest it will show in the this particular bar that, okay, how many records are matching there. Okay. So this, yes, any question?
Global search, there would be any probably thorough inputs or class in future for global search. I've seen global search has been taken down to very good content when it comes to optimizing that.
Right.
So uske liye kuch hoga future mein bhi?
Nahi, abhi as such kuch nahi, because the name indicates global search. It's basically you want to search anything, you can search from this particular place. I'm not sure that ServiceNow is building some other stuff on the top of that. Otherwise, the basic functionality of this option will be gone. So they want to keep it like that only. Okay.
Okay.
then all the things are there. So this is all about our system properties. Later you will find some text and font as well, that okay, how the font will be appear, all the things will be done that part. Okay. So in the nutshell, if I say that we have a lot of things available here, minimum you need to be know about the insert, stay, save, global search, roles required, application navigator, right click, or the email notification part. These things are mainly required. My recommendation say, if you find any kind of requirement कि मुझे ये नहीं देखना है या मुझे नहीं विजिबल होना चाहिए, then first of all go and search in the properties, and then you are able to identify it is coming from the properties, then find. If it not, then definitely there is some logic has been written in the background, then you can find out the cause for the same. Okay, now if I go here again the system properties, so we done this part. Email will see in the email part. Import export will see on the import export part specifically. Okay, now if you want to see the properties for the mobile app, click on this, because ServiceNow has its mobile app also. The general mobile app which is available called the ServiceNow Classics is there, I guess. Okay, so you want to see some settings on the top of that, you can do, but little bit settings are allowed, not much. UI is allowed or not, all these things will be there. Okay, then
so is this classic or is this mobile?
I guess it was classic, and now they come up with the mobile, right? Now mobile, right now it okay. They has renamed to the now mobile. Okay,
I haven't used a classic yet.
I use classic in the 2014-15. Okay, then if you want to make any change in the CSS files, definitely it's not our area, but still if you want to do, you can do that part. Change the font you want to do, all the things you can make it here. This is generally we never touch base, because these are the out of the box. If you make a change here and you do the upgrade, again it will go for the config part. So better not to make change anything here. It will nothing, it will just increase your font size or the length, all these things will be there. Now important is the system properties. This one. See, when I say the system properties, I'm talking on the ServiceNow system properties. See, up till now, what we done, those are applicable for the users, not for the system. But these are the applicable for the system, not for the users. Even though it is part of the system properties only, but these are to modify your system. Okay, maximum number of database joins per query. Only 10 you are allowed. Acceleration engine means these are basically from the development or the architect perspective, you can say. Number of updates displayed from when a record is initially created until records are omitted, up to 10 is the default. You can add that part. So many things are there, even though I never explore this area, because these are always the out of boundary for me. Okay. Prompt user to confirm a logout request. Yes, a physical update of the update of the database will only done when the fields change in the value. See, it is already set by ServiceNow as a yes, so let's not change it. Okay, items per page 150 2050. Maybe these things you are able to see, right? It is gone. This one, if you want to remove, you can remove it from here. I can remove from here this thing. Maintain a history of the records visited by each user. Yes, who is visiting my records, you can do that. But I guess this option is available in this area, activity stream. In this area you will be able to find that part. Okay, these things. Maximum length of a read. Yes,
Abdul, may you go on a list view please?
Yes, open please. Yep,
do you see there is a critical incident and there is a red checkbox, red small thing over there,
right?
And probably if we work on it, it might turn into green or something like that, yellow as well.
If you reduce the priority, it becomes other than that.
How to do that part? Probably we have discussed. I'm sorry, okay. If I missed.
No, we did not discuss. So basically, these are called the what I can say. There is a specific name for this thing. it's some text or some terminologies there. We need to be set that terminologies actually, and then you can make a color changes as well.
So these are coming under system properties or?
No, these are the configurations.
Okay.
These are the configuration. Let me see if I have any major incident. Major issue open. Let me show you something. Because I forget this name. Or let me show you. Here only. VIP, right? Wait, I'll show you. List. Okay. Let me go here. Anji Butter. Chai. Aata bas 5 minute mein. Theek hai, I'm just finding one name just to show you something which is similar to that only. VIP. Okay, God is great. Let's go here and put. Oh, it's already in the closed state, yeah. Now let me put. God is great. Right, Yenoska now. See, open record in the new window. Ye humne property set kiya abhi. God is great hat to yahi yaar is par chal gayi na God and God. Okay, it is God and God, not this one. See this one, right? This is coming from the what I can say, some flag picker is there. I forgot the exact name of this particular picker, so from there it has been come actually. So now it is critical, so it will show the red color. If you reduce the priority, let me put as a 2 and 2. Let's save this. So if you open this incident in the list view, okay, you will not find the red color there because now the priority has been reduced. But this is coming from a flag. I forget that flag. It is a configuration. You can do that part. Okay, I'll check and we'll update you in this case on Ankit.
Thank you.
Okay. So these are the things which you can make changes easily at your end. But remember, making changes in the system property will impact directly to all the users, irrespective of any type of role he or she has. So once you've done that part, always make sure that you are not changing those property which has a bad impact on the other users as well. Okay. Rest, you can do a lot of things out there. Maybe you can search for the global text property as well. Specific properties for this one. These you can change. Then you can do for the text search as well. If you want to search any text, simple query or something like that. But I can say you, okay, go and check for the home page properties. This one. Okay, then you can make a changes easily in that area. So now your homework is specifically, and you at least, if you did not get time to do the practical, at least read about the basic things. These two, three, one, two, three, four are important. Then you can go for the homepage and dashboard properties, because these are the things which always customer is interested to know about the same part. Okay, and at the last, if you want to go global text search or something like that, you want to search, you can go on that part easily. Okay, so this much we have done. Maybe in coming days also, if I get something new, I'll update you in the class as well. Okay, any doubt, any question? Anyone? Yes, go ahead.
No, go ahead, please.
Regarding the yesterday, while creating the group, it is asking to select the type, right? Like we have, while creating the group, we have selected the ITIN.
Right.
But for the users, it is not mandatory to select the type.
It is not mandatory. By default, it will come into that ITL only as a scripting done in the background. But if you want to specify, you can specify as well. Okay. Now let's do one thing. Let's see our update set. Okay, you can open the update set directly from here as well. And see what changes we have done, as it captured or not. Yes, it captured these properties. See, yes, no, yes, no, yes, no, it has been done. These many properties has been done. So this is the purpose of keeping the update set. Now what I will do, after some days, I'll close my update set and bring this update set to the Trunal or Kunal or Ankit PDI. And then all these changes will be applicable there as well. So that is the benefit of the update set. So today when you do something, or maybe tomorrow when you go for the this part, what I can say, table part, then your things will be captured in this area only. And from tomorrow onwards, almost things will be coming in the, what I can say, update sets only for you. Because tomorrow we have a topic called this thing, tables. And these are all the practical things we have to do one by one. Base part, table creation, modules, everything will be there. Okay. Any doubt, guys? Any question?
Go ahead.
Okay.
So, one of my customers wanted the size between those forms, right? Those boxes on the forms to be reduced. So, is that option also available through that user interface and this those way. Things? Yeah, we wanted that size to be reduced.
No. This is completely out of the box.
Okay.
And these tomorrow I'll show that how we can create these things as well. Okay, but and always one more thing, Ronald, maybe it is good for everyone. Customer always ask for the sky. Boss, I need everything on the place. And we are the consultant have to tell that, boss, it is a tool. And it has some limitation, it has some boundaries. Kal, dekho, wo bolega ki aap kar do. I'll not say that it is not possible. It can be possible, but it will be a complete customization. You have to design the complete CSS to put the fields here. Aaj koi do keh raha hai, kal bolega mujhe char columns chahiye yahan par. Then what you will do? Right? So these things is not possible. Because ServiceNow says that I am building a product on some standards. And when you're selling that product to your customer, you should also follow that standards always. That is the thing. Okay. And what is the business needs to do this, remove this gap? Kya milega usko remove karke? Ronald.
Got it. It was looking out of place at that time. Okay. So that's why he wanted it to be reduced.
And you can ask him that what business value I'm driving by reducing this size. Still, I'm able to see the complete page. On a screen, a complete page is opening, right? Aisa to nahi hai, mujhe yahan pe scroll karna pad raha hai. If that is the case, then I can still say, okay, boss, I need to do something. I'm on a single page, I'm able to see the complete fields. Then why you want to reduce it from here to here? Nothing you're going to be achieved. Right? That is the thing. Yes, go ahead, Ankit.
So we can't change the space of between. Can we change the tabs, tab size as well? Wherein if you scroll up, if you see the number tab, it's a bit long. And if you see the company one,
yes.
It's a bit
trim. Yes. This thing can be done, but I'll tell you one more thing here. Suppose you reduce the number to the 10, okay? And your company is 40 character. How it will look like then?
I got it.
Right? So that is the thing. If you want to see, you can go ahead and configure form layout. But you need to be see from the standard perspective. Today you will do, tomorrow your customer say, boss, kya form banaya tumne? Ab dekho, high impact urgency priority, ye kabhi change nahi hote. Iske liye maximum 6 character ya 8 character mein kaam ho jayega, but still they have a 40 characters just to maintain the complete standard format here, right?
Okay,
that is the thing.
Thank you.
No problem. Okay, guys, so I'm done from my side. If no other question, let me stop the recording and the screen sharing.